is Bloomberg UTV.
Welcome to another episode of Tech Tree. I'm your host, Alap. Now, I'm here in Kuruma to buy this awesome new game that came out last week. But before I do that, we'll go check out what we have on the show for you this week. On Tech Tree this week, we put some laptops on a crash diet. Forget 3G. Vishal tells us about 4G.
Clearly, it's the next generation of Wi-Fi.
And it's a duel between the tech and the tree.
You don't have that option to get someone to read to you, but you have that here.
Yeah, but it just isn't the same thing, right? Having someone read out to you
well,
versus
when you
were reading.
Your daddy read to you.
See, Dan Brown's new book, The Lost Symbol, didn't do as well as The Da Vinci Code. Because in Da Vinci Code, you actually felt like you were transported back into a time when the Templars and the Assassins were at war in ancient Rome. Now, those guys are not doing that publicly anymore. But if you want a piece of the action, there's a new game called Assassin's Creed 2 that lets you do exactly that.
Assassin's Creed 2 is an improvement over the original in every way. One of the main complaints about the first one was that at every level, the mission was just the same. Now that's been fixed in AC2. It's not simply about eavesdropping on conversations.
If we lose Lorenzo and Firenze falls to the Pazzi,
it will not come to that.
And then going for the find and the kill routine, there's a big variety of missions.
What are you and your allies planning? Is this what my father discovered?
It's set in 14th century Italy. The story is about Ezio Auditore. He's a descendant of earlier assassin Alter. And AC2 is a tale of revenge, of crimes against his family, and the conspiracies that surround them.
I'll kill you for what you've done!
Assassin's Creed 2 looks beautiful. It's set in Florence, in Tuscany, Rome, Venice. It is a visual treat.
Sure, it looks fantastic, but if there's one bad point I can pick, is that the game is actually very easy to play. Most of the fluid free-running and jumping sequences in the game can only be done using two buttons, but you still love it.
And while we are nitpicking, if you play the game on PS3, the animation gets choppy sometimes, but then even on Xbox 360, there's that slight issue of lower quality graphics. After all, it is on DVD.
So it's a spectacular action game and it's easily one of the best of the year. It costs only ₹2,600 for both the PS3 and the Xbox 360. But if you're a PC gamer, you're gonna have to wait till next year for that. Now, I've been told to stay away from my PlayStation and go out and get some exercise. But I have a better idea. I'm gonna have some nice diet food instead, if there is such a thing. So let's see what we have on the menu. I have these two juices here with me. This one is the fruity slim and trim. This one is the spinach infested 3210, which gets you from size 3 to size 0. Now, speaking of size 0, we've also got the new Sony Vaio X size 0 laptop.
Yup, you've been seeing a lot of that in commercial breaks.
We've got the thin and touchy-feely Dell Adamo XPS. And no diet can be complete without the thin and light MacBook Air. Now, I know what's in these two juices, fruits and spinach. Let's find out what's in all these laptops. This one is the smallest of the lot.
That's because the Vaio X has an 11.1-inch screen. The others have bigger 13-inch screens. So on size, there's a clear winner. Think slim and think Adamo XPS. At 9.9mm, it's the thinnest of the lot. It's also the thinnest in the world, so no competition there.
It runs a netbook processor. It runs the Atom. So performance is not its strongest point.
Then who takes the performance pie? Both the Dell and the MacBook run on an ultra-low voltage Core 2 Duo. The MacBook Air is the faster 1.8 GHz machine. A special word of mention for the angle the keyboard stands in on the Adamo XPS.
Once open, it forms into this stand-like thing, which is great if you want to put it on the desk. You know, it kind of gives you that elevation, which is good for typing. But once you put it on the lap, it tends to get a little uncomfortable after a while of use. So it isn't exactly a laptop per se. So which one of these should you get?
If you're looking for something compact, the Veo X is decent value for about 65,000 rupees. But if your second car is a C-Class Merc, the Dell Adamo XPS will fit right in after putting down 1.5 lakh rupees.
I would choose the MacBook Air because it has a better processor. It's the best performing one of the lot. It runs two operating systems. So even though it costs about 1 lakh, which is 35,000 bucks more than the Sony Veo X, I think it's still better value for money because you can do a lot more stuff with this. So the MacBook Air is my pick.
So now that you've got a slim laptop, why not pair it up with a slim MP3 player? Sony's got a new E-Series Walkman, so let's see how it stacks up against the iPod Nano.
The new Sony NWZ-E440 series Walkman is a portable media player that does audio, video, photos, FM radio, and voice recording. It's light, slim, yet very thick compared to the iPod Nano. The control pad is simple and doesn't match up to the iPod's touch wheel. The display is big enough to browse your music, but not for watching videos. And well, when it comes to games, this one has none.
One good thing about the Sony is that you don't have to use just one application to manage all your music. You can use Windows Media Player or even iTunes, which is pretty cool.
What's also cool is the sound quality. It's stellar, and the bundled earphones make it even better.
Here's the thing. The Sony is decent value for money at about 7,000 bucks, but it doesn't have anything outstanding. For a little extra money, you get the iPod Nano, which is much slimmer, it has games, it even has a video camera. So I think the Sony is a skip. Besides, what would you rather say? I have an iPod or I have an NWZ-E444? We'll take a little break now, but you go watch this video of this crazy long multi-touch wall. We'll be right back.